Congratulations on the championship. Can you just give us your opening thoughts on an eventful day here at the stadium?
Well, first, a hearty congratulations to East Carolina on a terrific year. They'll go out and represent the conference outstanding like they always do. And, you know, to be the champ, you got to beat the champs, you know, and then they've done it for a long time and represent this thing at a first-class manner. So to be able to beat them, you know, and for them to have to go through all the things they went through the loser's bracket to get to where they were was extra special for us, for sure. You know, a lot of heroics, you know, Dylan coming back after 108 pitches or whatever it was, and Jonah Wachter and Colin Riley and Ricky Castro again to come out for the third time. Just, you know, you go up and you score three in the first and you turn around and give up a four spot. And, you know, again, resilient all week and pretty much all season with what we've been through. And so, you know, I think at some point it's just, you know how to navigate through those kind of things. So just really, really proud of the guys and happy for them. Like I said, it's been a trying year and they stepped up and had their best focus and intent at the right time of the year for sure. And now we get to take that in our jar with the lid on it and take it to the next weekend, which is really cool.
Go to questions, please. Start with Gary Smith, please.
Jay, T.O. Banks didn't hit any home runs today. All he did was get singles in his first three at-bats, then scored the last run too. On top of that, tournament's most outstanding player. Just what can you say about his performance all week long?
I think the performances spoke for themselves. I mean, he is intently focused, hyper-athletic, ultra-competitive, a winner in every sense. And so, you know, when he's up there, I think we all feel good. And just, again, the things that he went through early in the year that mirrored our team struggles, for him to finish this weekend off or this week off the way he has is, again, it takes, you know, some of those were solos and, you know, manufacturing himself. But, you know, his teammates got to get on base and allow him to drive them in. So just a lot of great team things. And I'm sure he would say the same. But what a spectacular performance by him and many others.
You knew you could score runs against this team at this point of the tournament. You've been doing it all tournament. But the pitching performances you got after the rough start, you kind of enumerated them. But just either guys that weren't used to being in that role or guys that really hadn't proven themselves on this stage, one after the other kept coming through.
And I mean, those are the kinds of stories that show up this time of the year, you know, when you're taxed for what you have and guys haven't had opportunities or have had their opportunities limited because of, you know, a lack of performance. You know, that's baseball and that's the way it goes. But you always have to be ready when your name is called, whether it's off the bench or a pinch starting role as a position player or out of the bullpen. And, you know, the way those young guys came out of the pen was really big boost for us. And you could see it when I went out to get the ball from them, the appreciation and happiness that their teammates had for those guys' performance. And because you know how hard you work to try to get those results. And when they don't come, it's tough. But when they do come and they come in big moments, you got to want the moment. They wanted the moment and they were able to execute. And so just really outstanding performances by those guys.
We'll go to Rod Walker next, please.
Hey, Jay, what's sort of your message to the team at these points during the season when things weren't looking good? And, you know, how'd you kind of keep them up?
I always just try to operate on the principle as what would I do if we were winning? I try to behave the same as much as I can. And certainly frustrations can boil over and demands kind of get higher. And when you're not playing well, sometimes it's a little more difficult to take coaching. But I try to do it from a place of love and I try to do a place of growth and development. And, you know, in my role as the head coach is to sometimes give them more leash than maybe they deserve at times for the learning experience. And then to be able to tighten that chain when it needs to be tightened. But I've just tried to stay consistent in the messaging and that's keep plugging away, keep pounding away, keep getting better every day. And, you know, this week, I just felt it from them. I get on the bus to talk to them before practice or after practice or before a game and after a game. And I just saw a different I wouldn't call it the light switch, but I just saw a different sort of focus. And when you're around people every day, and some people have good feel for, you know, body language and so forth. And I may not be the smartest guy in America, but I think I do have some pretty decent emotional intelligence. And I just have a good feel for them when they're in a good place, when they're not in a good place. And I can tell you without hesitation that from the time that we left New Orleans to the time we got here, particularly after the Memphis deal, we were trying to set up our pitching. They understood that the results, you know, weren't great at the end of the trail of conference play, but they knew the bigger picture, and they were committed to being intentful and purposeful. And that's exactly what we got all week. They were, and they were resilient, and they were gritty, and, you know, every adjective you can use, they showed it. And just supremely proud of them and their efforts and who they are as people. And, you know, sometimes I get frustrated at them and they get frustrated at me, and that's just relationships. My wife gets frustrated at me, you know, and vice versa. Those are when you're around people every single day and you're fighting for a common goal. And it's easy when things are going well, but when things aren't going well, it really tests every ounce of your patience, your trust, your belief. And I've tried to give them the same message, the consistent message, over the course of time. And, you know, hopefully it's stuck. And, you know, they play the game. I stand over there in the corner and cheerlead. So just, again, proud of them for their performances.
I had one quick follow-up. Can you describe the moment when the ball pops up to the final out? What was that moment like to you, and what went through your mind?
We were positioned that way. Coach Brill keeps a really good book. And as soon as I saw it go up in that direction, it's just a matter of watching it in, but you could feel the anticipation of that third out, like you see it on TV so many times. And as soon as that ball landed in Brady's glove, it was euphoria, you know, it was hugs. And I didn't even get a chance to see it. And Curtis, our ops director, and I were mauling each other, and I tried to get to my assistants in the other corner. They were mauling each other. So, you know, those are the things, man. When people don't believe and they lose faith, and you don't, and you hang in there, and those kind of things show up, it makes it extra special for the journey.
Hey, we'll take another from Mark Keplinger, please.
Hey, Coach. I know this season, you know, at least the regular season, didn't go quite the way, you know, you or any of the players wanted to, but do you feel like, you know, getting this conference tournament championship, is that almost like a vindication of, you know, the job that you did, and also just how talented the players are and how good they can be?
Yeah, I mean, I the players play. I appreciate you saying that, and I appreciate you, Mark. You've been awesome all year. We'll keep this rolling, right? But I don't, vindication, I mean, yeah, I mean, you do play to try to prove people wrong, and at least that's kind of my nature. But you know, the season wasn't per se what we wanted, but it is a long season. And as long as there's breath in the lungs, you have a chance to be in the fight. And we had breath in our lungs, and we had to be beaten twice to be eliminated. And when you got kids that believe and want it and have a want, these kinds of things show up. So really proud of the job that they've done. I'm really, really proud of the guys.
Speaking about two guys in particular, Dylan Carmouche and Ricky Castro, I know they're on very short rests, throwing, you know, close to 100 pitches or over 100 pitches for both of them. You know, what can you say about, you know, the two of them and their, and what they were able to do today?
Yeah, I mean, we don't get there without those two guys, first and foremost. And then we don't get through that game without their contributions, you know. So when our guys see those two guys on the mound, I know I feel really good about it, and I think they do too. I know they do too. So great contributions from them, and I think they would have lined up to knock me out if we wouldn't have put them in the game. So, you know, I wasn't going to hold that back, and at the same time, we weren't going to try to put them in a position where we hurt them or ruin their arms either. And, you know, we probably could have ran Dylan back out, but when we had a little lengthened inning and got a little space, we sat him down and just passed the ball to Jonah. So.
Another one from Gary, please.
Two things. One, with Ricky Castro, you didn't have a lot of options with the two Michaels unavailable after pitching late last night, as long as they did. But did you just want a guy, a veteran guy, on the mound for that type of situation at the end? Because it hadn't gone well for him earlier in the tournament.
Yeah, and Billy was down there too. So if we had to go to Billy, we were there. And so we were just ready to, you know, empty the tank and do whatever we had to do. If it was Ricky getting two outs and Billy come in for one or vice versa, then that's what we were going to do. The job that those guys did, we don't get to that part today without their contributions.
And while they reviewed the caught stealing, how worried were you? It was a bang bang play. So yeah.
I just kept repeating self-affirmation of we're going to win this game. We're going to win. I mean, I said it over and over and over and over and over until that guy came out of there and said the call stood. So, I believe in the power of thought, and I believe in the power of how you think. So it's just kind of who I am.
Pick last one from Rod Walker, please.
Hey Jay, what's it just going to be like on Monday, just, getting a chance to sit around the TV and see Tulane pop up on the screen? What's that going to feel like for you, and the players?
It's going to be a proud moment. We have a lot of proud alumni that have been waiting for this for a little bit. And, they've had to endure our pain, too, over the course of this. But I can tell you, without their support via text, via email, via phone calls, via stops by practice. We had, Robbie Segedin was out here a couple times this week. We saw him, and without their support, it wouldn't be as sweet, and so it's going to be a real prideful moment for me, particularly because I know how important this program is to not only them, but to a lot of people. There were a lot of great years at Tulane. And so for us to be able to get back into the postseason is very meaningful. And it's meaningful for this program moving forward, and our players having this opportunity to go through this week and this kind of environment and be battle tested that way, but also what we've gone through the season. We get to go on the road, which we've been on plenty. And so for us to be able to see our names pop up on the screen, it's going to be a lot of fun to see that. And, wherever it is we're going, we're going to have our heads down and try to be the grittiest team and get after it.
Coach Ullman, thank you for your time today, this week, and congratulations. Best of luck the rest of the way.
Appreciate y'all. Thanks so much, guys.
All right. We'll bring in a couple student athletes here. First, we'll start with T.O. Banks, most outstanding player of the tournament. And we can go ahead with questions, please. Start with Mark, please.
T.O., after the St. John's series, I talked to Jackson. He kind of said that this is a very talented team, and, they're just a little bit away from turning that corner and really getting getting your stride going. I know it took, a little bit longer than just after that first series, but do you guys feel like you finally did and you're finally starting to hit your stride now that, obviously you won the conference tournament, but you're, heading into the postseason?
Yeah, I would say that is the case. I said it yesterday, but I think when you got talent and then when you put that talent together with everybody's on the same page and everybody, knows what they're going for, it's good things happen.
Dylan and Ricky, they were on short rest, but they were able to provide a lot of very important outs for you. Can you just speak to them a little bit and their performance today?
Yeah, those dudes are some beasts. They got some grit. I'm in pitcher every now and then, but I know it's hard. I don't know how they do it. I mean, props to them.
Go to Gary Smith for the next, please.
Tio, what was this team's mindset going into the tournament? You guys played with extreme confidence from the very start. Obviously, you knew you had to win it to keep playing this season. And just how did you get that positivity going after what went on during the regular season?
Yeah, our mindset was to win it, as cliche as it sounds. But, we just saw that as a new opportunity to start a new season and capitalize on that. And the results rewarded us.
There was one pitch today, I think it, before your third hit, guy hung one, you got out in front of it, your eyes got big, two strikes. Maybe earlier in the season you would have struck out. Instead, you just hit a sharp opposite field single the other way. Just how confident are you right now? And how big do you feel like was just that swing when you missed an opportunity on the pitch before?
Yeah. After that swing, I was just trying to see it deep, and I believe there was runners on first and second. I think one out, maybe zero. And I was just trying to do a job. So whether that was get in the air to get the runner from second to third or drive him over, just something simple. And, you know, the result ended up something better, but I'll take that.
And were you nervous during the replay review after on the stolen base call in the ninth inning, or you?
No, I wasn't.
Thanks.
Okay, next one from Rod Walker, please.
Congrats on the award. Just kind of what was going on through your mind when the last out as the ball was in the air and you're just kind of waiting for it to come down?
Yeah, almost not know what to do. Like, felt like I didn't know what to do a little bit, and then once everyone starts running in, it's just kind of blank out a little bit. Just everyone tugging each other, water being thrown everywhere. Just a great feeling.
How frustrating did it get at times this season when the wins weren't coming? And how did you all navigate through that?
Yeah, I think it's very frustrating. But I think you also got to understand that baseball is a hard game. And no matter how hard you try, how much work you put in, it can still go the opposite way. But I think if you keep at it, keep faith, keep believing in God, things go your way. And I think as a team, that's what we did and ended up working out.
And my last question, what's it going to be like tomorrow morning? Well, at noon tomorrow, I guess, sitting in front of the TV and seeing Tulane's name pop on the screen.
Yeah, it's going to feel great. I think we're going to get some sleep first. It was a quick turnaround today.
Dale, thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, bringing in pitcher Jonah Wachter. And we can start with Rod Walker, if you're available.
Okay, yeah, I think my hand was just left up from last time. But right. No, that's fine. Just kind of describe the moment of, you know, when the last out happened and getting to celebrate after all you all went through this season.
It's indescribable. Just pure happiness. Just being with everyone. This group, we were all resilient, and we wanted this so bad. And I think that it just paid off, and I can't even put it into words.
Go to Gary Smith for the next, please.
Jonah, like a lot of the bullpen, you'd struggled for a large portion of this year, but you came up huge today. Just what was your mindset on the mound, and your how good did you feel like your stuff was today?
I just wanted to help my team win. We all wanted this so bad. And I knew that when my name got called to go in the game that I had to step up and I had to keep us in the ball game so that we could put ourselves in the best seat to win. Overall, I felt pretty good. Early on, I was a little shaky, walked a couple guys. And then as I went on, my pitches, I started locating better. But there's still a little nerves there.
Did you want to stay in when you came out? Because you just gotten a pretty routine fly
ball. I wasn't even really thinking about it. I mean, I knew that the guys that we had going in the bullpen were going to be able to get the job done. So when my time got called, I was ready to hand the ball off to them. So I will never question any of that.
What do you feel like? What allowed you guys to believe that you could win this tournament? Because it was clear watching each game that you guys did believe. But with the season you'd had, how did you get to that point?
Just the fact that all of us, we're super talented. We all knew that. We knew that we had this opportunity, and that it was the conference was open. There was good competition, but we were right there. A lot of the games throughout the year, we were in close battles. So we were confident. We knew that we had a good shot to win it. And I just think that, we had a good shot to win it, and the conference was open. So we just played our best baseball at the right time.
Thank you.
Next one from Mark, please.
Jenna, I know you alluded to it earlier, but you got yourself into a couple of jams early on, but you were able to get out of them. So what was your mindset through them, and what helped you get out of those situations?
So early on in the year, like against some of the first opponents we had, I would kind of give in to the pressure, and I would just think back to those times where I would just like give in, and it would just be such a bad feeling of like not helping my team win. So that really motivated me. And I just tried to like bottle that up and use that as like a fuel for my fire.
All right. Any other final questions?